What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. I'm recording up on my roof right now, which I am pretty excited about because my roof has been closed since everything started to lock down in March. But like the rest of the country, Seattle is slowly trying to reopen, and now we're allowed back up here. For this week's video, I was planning on going over the recent protests and how they inform what we know about the pandemic and how this virus spreads. But while I was doing that research, I kept running into examples of just how frustrated and angry people are around this question of what's safe in a pandemic and what we should and shouldn't be allowed to do. And it kept making me think of a topic that I really enjoy thinking about, something that I call mixed feedback signals. And while we try to reopen, we have been getting massive mixed feedback signals. I mean, there are certain places in the country where they're just trying to reopen restaurants and stores, and they're getting massive outbreaks. Meanwhile, other cities have been having these massive protests, and they don't seem to be having the same types of outbreaks. And that can be really frustrating. Admittedly, a lot of that anger is political, but a lot of it is just because people want to know what is safe to do and they don't feel like they can get a clear answer. So we're going to still go over what the protests teach us about the pandemic, but I'm also going to talk a little bit about these mixed feedback signals and how we can work with them in our daily life to actually make better decisions and make decisions that we can be a little bit happier with. But before we do that, I think I'm going to go back inside because the audio is not too great out here and frankly, it's still kind of cold. So I'll be right back with you after the jump. All right, so let's dig into this a little bit. What exactly are mixed feedback signals? Mixed feedback signals are when you are working on something, you're trying to accomplish something, maybe learn something new, succeed in a situation, and the results that you're getting from your work are not clear. You're getting mixed feedback signals. Sometimes they conflict with one another or even completely contradict each other. Actually, one second, I think I have a good example of this. So as you've probably already noticed, I like houseplants quite a bit. Learning what each individual plant needs to survive is one of my favorite hobbies. And this right here, this is an African violet. This is one of the first plants that I ever got. And when I brought it home, it had some of these purple flowers on top, but they quickly died and fell off. And I've spent the last year or so doing a lot of trial and error, trying to figure out what are the most optimal conditions for this plant to get these flowers back. And as you can see, in the last few weeks, they've returned. And it's made me really happy. I get really excited about that because it's a positive feedback signal. It's a result that suggests that I'm doing something right. But at the same time, if you look at some of these outside leaves, they're yellowing, they're kind of pale. Some of them even show outright damage. That's a negative feedback signal. That's a result that suggests that I'm doing something wrong. And these type of mixed feedback signals are everywhere in our lives and they can be incredibly frustrating. Let's relate that to what we're dealing with in the pandemic. As we start to reopen the economy, we're seeing mixed feedback signals at a massive scale. In some places where they're just trying to reopen stores and restaurants, we're seeing these really big outbreaks happening. Meanwhile, in cities where they might have had Memorial Day celebrations or large protests, you're not seeing the same type of outbreak, and that can be really confusing. Now, a lot of the anger and frustration around this is admittedly around politics because, like everything in America, the pandemic has become politically polarized. But for a lot of people, we just want to feel safe. We want to know what we can and cannot do. And these mixed signals make it really hard to figure that out. But having mixed feedback signals doesn't mean that you still can't get really high quality information that informs your decision making. Let's take the protest, for example. We've had enough time since those protests started that if they were going to be large virus vectors, we would have seen it by now, but we really haven't. Why? Now, the first reason why protests didn't turn into vectors for virus actually kind of surprised me quite a bit. In the cities that had large protests, data shows that social distancing actually increased. So even though we saw large crowds on TV, overall more people were staying home, both because of the nature of the coverage of those crowds, but also because in a lot of those cities, we had regular curfews that meant that most people had to be inside by a certain time. So just less people were being around other folks. Also, we're getting more and more data about how it's just really difficult for this virus to spread outdoors. When I was doing research for this video, I came across somebody named Lindsay Marr. She's a expert in airborne transmission at Virginia Tech. And she was describing how the atmosphere outside makes it particularly difficult for the virus to stay concentrated in those infectious droplets. So even a light breeze can diffuse and dilute them, and you don't get that indoors. Specifically, when you're indoors in air-conditioned places, those same droplets are just kind of circulating and staying in the atmosphere. They don't get dispersed like they do outside. And finally, and look, I know this has become a really politicized part of the pandemic, but it seems like most of the protesters were wearing masks. I'll be the first one to admit that I was skeptical about masks when the lockdown first started, but even I always have mine with me because there's too much evidence that if you're pre-symptomatic, asymptomatic, or just a carrier, it's going to be that much harder for you to spread the virus around if you're wearing a mask, and we shouldn't be denying that data. The reason why mixed feedback signals are frustrating is because it can make it difficult for us to see nuances in decisions that seem really similar but have really different outcomes. Let's look at restaurant reopening as an example. In some places, once restaurants were allowed to reopen, there weren't that many restrictions on them. So they kind of just went back to normal. And especially in places where people are relying heavily on air conditioning, it turned out to be a really dangerous decision and outbreaks got really bad. In other places, when restaurants were allowed to reopen, there were still a lot of restrictions on them. They had to keep a really low capacity, which allowed people to maintain adequate social distance, and they enforced masks. So those decisions turned out not to be as dangerous, and the rising cases aren't as bad. So it wasn't just as easy as saying opening restaurants is dangerous or opening restaurants is safe. And if you had an emotional reaction to those results that caused you to privilege one outcome that you wanted to happen over another outcome that wasn't what you wanted to happen, you're liable to miss that nuance. Mixed feedback signals are everywhere. It's really hard to avoid them. You're going to run into them at work when you're trying to do a better job. You're going to run into them when you're trying to be a better partner or a better friend, or when you're just trying to take care of your African violets. If we want to mitigate the frustration that they cause, the best that we can do is try to be mindful of when we're having emotional responses to results so that we can decrease the chance that we're missing really valuable nuance. Thanks for stopping by for another video. I really appreciate that you're watching these, and I hope that they're getting better over time. That really is my main goal right now. Be sure to comment down below about these issues that we're talking about. I'm really enjoying having these conversations, and the more that people engage, the better the conversation will get as we go along. Like the video and subscribe to the channel. Share it with your friends. I want to get more people involved. I love talking to you, and we'll do it again next week.